make and take and lot many things. And today is the National Mathematics Day, and I think all of you are aware. I need not to tell why we are celebrating. That's for celebrating the birthday of the genius in mathematics, Ramanujan ji. So I will not take much time on that side, but I will request all of you to participate in all our programs. There will be more lectures, storytelling sessions, and quiz, and many more things. I think you can go on our website and find out what are the different programs where you can participate. There will be film shows also. So not many things are there. And we keep on doing programs. I think many of you have been participating. That's why. So first of all, a big thank you for registration and coming back and joining us. Today, you know, mathematics is very interesting subject. In fact, many people are afraid of it. But even in today morning, we are asking, why we should be afraid of it? It's a very lovely subject. It's very interesting. It is there in our body. It is there in the nature everywhere around us. Whatever you like, whatever you, something very appealing or pleasing to your eyes, perhaps you'll find there must be some mathematics in that. Every photograph doesn't appeal you. But there are certain compositions, and you'll find there must be some mathematics behind that, which makes it very convenient for you. Sometimes people ask why we should read mathematics, what application they have. But yesterday, if you would have attended lecture, perhaps would have been easier to understand whether you play cricket, whether you play hockey, whether you play any game. So mathematics is there. Whether the ball is falling or if you are throwing the ball or projectile motion, though it's covered under projectile motion, maybe in physics or, but basically there is mathematics inside that. Okay, so in computers, in your body, in your Aadhaar card or biometrics or your identity, somewhere in the, everywhere you will find the mathematics. So we cannot avoid it. Okay, and keeping that, we have brought you today a fascinating lecture about this fascinating world of mathematics and some very interesting application which will be shared with you by Professor Anil Kumar Yadav. Just briefly, I will introduce you all about Professor Anil Kumar Yadav. He is a professor of mathematics and director of MIT School of Applied Sciences in Gurugram, Haryana. He has received his MSc and PhD from IIT Delhi and did his postdoctoral research at North Carolina State University and St. Joe's State University, USA. In his academic career, which is almost spread over 25 years, he has worked at government as well as private institutions. These include IIT Delhi, Guru Jameshwar University in Hisar, which is in Haryana, the North Cape University, and MIT University, Gurugram, where currently he is posted. He has been actively engaged in teaching, research, and administration in various capacities, including HOD, which is head of the department, deputy dean, dean, and now director, which is currently is holding that post. Dr. Yadav has visited several universities overseas and academic research and collaboration assignment. He has been supervising doctoral research besides guiding UG postgraduate projects. His research interests, they include air quality modeling analysis. Perhaps everybody in the morning in newspaper and news channel, you find out this air quality index, AQI. Particularly people around Delhi or sometime in Mumbai also, they say quality, hawa ka quality bahut kharab hai. Model evaluation, health impact assessment. During corona, you might have come across many, many mathematical model, how it will spread, what will be the outcome, where we will be there. So all simulations also, there it is used. And image processing as well. He has published nearly 100 research papers in journals of international repute and international conferences. He has contributed a few books, chapters, and an edited a book also was edited by him. Dr. Yadav has been PI and COPI of a few sponsored projects funded by DST, UGC, DRDO, and HP. The recent one is the prestigious DST FISH grant of 84 lakh in physical sciences awarded to MIT School of Applied Sciences under his leadership. He has organized several national and international conferences. He has been a part of strategic planning team for developing comprehensive policy framework and core academic settings. several prize also he has, and ownership fellowship he has been awarded and won. One of them is Hewlett-Packard 2009 Innovation in Engineering Education Grant worth $1,70,000. Leadership Award in the year 2009 for Indo-US collaboration for engineering education. Then Best Paper Award in 2015, PARC, North Carolina University, Gurgaon. Recipient of Research Fellowship based on GATE during PhD. Research Fellowship of UGC through NET. And just let me add one more thing that this program, which we have planned or during 4 days next, it is also being supported by DST and through RGST, which is Rajiv Gandhi Science and Technology Commission of Government of Maharashtra. So with this brief, we are going to hand over the session now and the mic and stage to Professor Yadav to start his deliberation. Over to you, Dr. Yadav.
Thank you very much, Mr. Umesh Rustagi. At the outset, I would like to express my gratitude to the Nehru Science Center, Mumbai, for giving me this opportunity to interact and make a brief presentation of fascination towards mathematics with the young and very, very enthusiastic children. In fact, when I see all the children, it actually brings a lot of energy and enthusiasm in me. Although it also brings a major challenge to me that conveying mathematical stuff to children is a bigger challenge than teaching mathematics to students at the university level, especially at the undergraduate and postgraduate and PhD levels. So it's a massive challenge, and I'm really not sure to what extent I'll be able to meet the expectations of the participating children. But then I'm extremely delighted to see young and very, very enthusiastic participants today. This is a unique experience for me. So let me start with the sharing of my screen, because I also want to tell you, in just to add to what Mr. Umesh has just now shared, that we are celebrating National Mathematics Day today. In fact, we at Amity University are also celebrating this day with 1 day symposium starting in the morning, and it is just concluded. And also, I would like to tell you that all over the country, this particular week, entire week, is being celebrated. So it's not just a day, it's actually the entire week which is being celebrated all over the country. So I'm glad that our young children are also joining in celebrating this National Mathematics Day. Is my screen visible to you? Okay, great. So I'll begin with a few things about mathematics. Mathematics is the language of nature. And there's no better tool out there to study and learn about the world and the universe in general other than mathematics. We actually use mathematics in our daily lives, as Mr. Rustagi has said, from buying things to calculating our calorie intake to stay fit, looking at the AQIs to decide whether to go out, whether it is safe to actually play in the open or restrict ourselves to indoor games. Hence, it is not just important for mathematicians or physicists, but for everyone. For most people, mathematics, especially the students, is considered to be a difficult subject. But the thing is that what makes math difficult for many students is that it takes patience and persistence. And for many, math is not something that comes intuitively or automatically. It actually takes plenty of effort. So it's a subject that sometimes requires students to devote time and a lot of energy as well. mathematics is also people from engineering, they always say that mathematics is the language of engineering. And as Mr. Rustvi also pointed out, there is a very strong relationship between physics and mathematics. They are actually intertwined. Some person explained that mathematics is like skeleton and physics is like flash around the skeleton. So then only you get something meaningful out if you look at mathematics and physics together. Without mathematics, perhaps physics would not be all that great, and without physics again mathematics would be incomplete. So that is how the mathematics has so much close relationship and association with other fields of science. Very famous mathematicians of modern times, William Paul Thurston, who was awarded the Fields Medal very recently. Fields Medal is the highest prize in mathematics, equivalent to Nobel Prize. And what he said is, mathematics is not about numbers, equations, computations, or algorithms. It's about understanding. So young children, you are exposed to numbers, equations, and you think that this is all mathematics. It's actually much more than that. And soon you will discover as you move further that it is much more than all this, and you need to focus on understanding. Just to go ahead and tell you what is important in life, one of the most important skills that you need to develop is problem-solving skills. And mathematics helps you develop that problem-solving skills. At times, my students ask me, why are we studying this topic? And I tell them that, are you interested in developing your problem-solving skills? Problem-solving doesn't mean only mathematical problem-solving. It means any kind of problems in life. So if you are keen on developing or sharpening those skills, mathematics will help you do that. And it has been very beautifully explained by this mathematical analogy, which you see in the form of a very simple equation. 1.00 to the power 365, that means 365 days, it remains 1. What is so significant about it? Now, as we know that this day is having so much significance in the life of each one of us and for the country, this was actually the National Mathematics Day was declared in the year 2012 when it was by Honorable Prime Minister of India, Dr. Manmohan Singh, declared that particular year, 2012, as the National Mathematics Year. And since then, we have been celebrating this. So, in honor of the great mathematician, postal stamps were released. We also have a novel and a movie made on the life of Srinivas Ramanujan, the man who knew infinity. I think many of you would have also watched this movie, The Man Who Knew Infinity. This is a very interesting number, 1729. It is called Ramanujan Hardy number. I'm not sure whether you have heard of G.H. Hardy, famous British mathematician's name, which is very closely connected with the Srinivas Ramanujan's name. Once Ramanujan, when he was in UK he was visiting Professor Hardy, he fell ill and Hardy went to meet Ramanujan at his place. So, you know, and when he entered and saw him, he said that the taxi that I traveled by, it has a very dull and boring number. And when Ramanujan asked, what was that number? He said, 1729. Immediately, that was the genius of Ramanujan. Immediately, Ramanujan said that it is not a boring number or a dull number. It's very interesting number. And how it is interesting? He immediately said that it is the smallest number which can be expressed as sum of two cubes in two different ways. So you could see 1 cube plus 12 cube is 1729, and 9 cube plus 10 cube is also 1729. That is the genius that India has produced. Another German American mathematician, Richard Courant, who made significant impact, he famously said mathematics is an expression of human mind. It reflects the active will, the contemplative reason, and the desire for aesthetic perfection. Its basic elements are logic, intuition, analysis, and construction, generality, and individuality. I was just trying to tell you that how, you know, people have seen mathematics as such important in our lives. I'm not going to go over it because of the shortage of time. I just want to tell you that there is a Ramanujan Prize for Young Mathematicians, and this year it was given to Professor Nina Gupta from Bengal for her significant contribution. For children, I just want to recall this. You know, it's important to know that there was a kind of anecdote from Ramanujan's life. During his stay in the school, people used to notice the special gift that Ramanujan had. I mean, the gifted mathematician that he was. The classmates, they used to rush to him for, you know, solving the mathematical problems. While he was in eighth standard, he was challenging the teachers. And one day, a teacher pointed out that anything divided by itself was one. And many of you as children, you also would be believing that if you divide 5 by 5, you get 1. If you divide 10 by 10, you get 1. So teacher pointed out that anything divided by itself was 1. And he gave an example like divide 3 fruits among 3 people, each one will get 1. So Ramanujan immediately asked that if 0 is divided by 0, will it also give 1? That means if no fruits are divided among no one, will still each one get 1? And that is what actually baffled everyone. That was the genius when, and he could display that even in his 8th standard. Now I'll spend a few minutes going over the beauty of Ramanujan's magic square. If you look at it, is the same, these are the same numbers, okay? If you add the elements of the first row, you get 139. Likewise, you add the numbers in each row, you get 139, the same number. Also, if you add the elements in each column, the numbers in each column, still you will be able to get the same number, 139. Not only that, you add the numbers on the diagonal, principal diagonal, that is from top to bottom, top left to bottom right, you still get 139. You add the numbers on the other diagonal, you still get It's the same number, 139. Not only that, you add the numbers on the corners, four corners. Again, you get 139. The story doesn't end here. If you look at the sum of these colored squares of the same color, four squares of the same color, they'll get you the same number, 139. Again, if you look at these numbers, you know, on the off diagonal elements on either side, they will also give you the same number. Must be wondering, when will this story end? If you look at the sum of the central four squares, they are also 139. If you look at the sum of the top left four squares, again, sum is 139. Top right, bottom left, bottom right. Everything is again giving you the same sum. Also, you look at the middle rows and the same colors, you get the same thing. Now, finally, the climax is that Ramanujan was born on 22nd December 1887, and you look at the top row, it is 22nd of 12th month, that is December 1887. And unfortunately, he died on 26th April 1920 at a young age of about 32. So this is brief about Ramanujan, and I thought it is worth paying respect, tribute to such a mathematical genius Mother India has produced. Now I come to some applications which I thought I'll be sharing with you. And I'll keep it only to a very basic level so that every children understands. Now, the first one is principle. As children, I don't know if they understand the meaning of investment, but they definitely would know how to save money. So saving money is something that parents start teaching from a young age. And obviously, children, they would also, you know, find it exciting to start saving money early. But this principle of 72 says that if you want to double your money in, say, 5 years, so you have 72 and you have 5, right? So divide 72 by 5, that is the rate of increase that you must have annually in order to double your money. To keep it simple, if you want to double your money in, say, 6 years, so if you divide 72 by 6, you get 12. So your rate of return should be 12% every year, okay? And likewise, you could if you know the rate of interest, you can get the time in which you will be able to double your money. And this is something very simple you can work out, principle of 72. Now, again, what are friendly numbers? These two numbers are said to be friendly to each other. Now, why they are friendly to each other? What is the friendship between these two numbers? Again, if you look at 220 and look at and write down all its divisors, starting from 1, 2, 5, and so on, go up to the last one, that is 220. And similarly, you write down the divisors of 284, starting from 1, and you go up to 284. What you do, you actually, from these list of divisors, you exclude the number itself. You exclude 220 from the first one and 284 from the second one, and find the sum of the remaining divisors. And you could see, if you find the sum of divisors of 220, it actually sums up to 284. And likewise, if you add the divisors of 284, excluding the last one, 284 itself, you will get 220. And the beauty is that Ramanujan explained that an ideal friendship should be like these numbers, that they should complement each other. Even when one is absent, the other should represent the friend. So that is the friendship between these two numbers, 220 and 284. Now, coming to another example of demonstrating the principle of compounding, and which can help you in your investment. You know, if you look at this table, you know, it is about, you know, two people or two friends. They approached, you know, their teacher, and the teacher said that I have two schemes. One, I will give you 2 paisa on the first day, but then I will double it the next day. Whereas he said the second scheme is that I'll give you 1 lakh rupees on day one, and I'll give you another 1 lakh on day two, another 1 lakh on day three. So I will keep adding 1 lakh every day. Okay. So the first scheme gave 6 lakhs after 6 days, whereas the second scheme, where he started with 2 paisa, after 6 days reached to 64 paisa. You see, it is doubling 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, and 64. Here it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay. Now, he said that I'll continue this scheme for 1 month. Let's see where we reach. So, after 6th day, if you see, 7th day, 8th, and 10th. On the 10th day, the first one gets 10 lakh, whereas the second one gets only 10 rupees 24 paisa. Look at the difference. It is too much. Okay. Then if we continue further, say beyond 10 days, you will be able to see that the numbers keep growing. And by 20th day, the first one gets 20 lakhs. The second one is still struggling at 10,485.76, okay, on a daily basis. But if you look at cumulative, if you keep adding all the money that the person has got, it actually becomes 20,971. Compare 20,971 with 20 lakh. There is so much of difference. Now, if you look at this, 25th day, the first one gets 25 lakhs, whereas the second one has accumulated 6,71,000. It is caught up, but still far away. On the 30th day, you see the first one has got 30 lakhs. The second one, cumulative sum is 21,474. I'm sorry. It is... how much? 2,14,74,836. Right? So, this is what is the difference in a simple growing and in a compounded growing. So, this principle of compounding can actually create a big difference. And all of the children, they need to understand the principle of compounding, and they need to start investing wisely, or saving wisely, I would say. Okay. I would like to break this sequence with a little bit of fun involved. Dancing with maths. You know, there is one funny thing that goes around, that a student asks ma'am whether there will be a step marking, and the ma'am says it's not dance, it is maths. But I actually feel that, you know, you can dance with maths also. And you have a few examples here. Those of you who have exposure to functions and who have exposure to trigonometry can actually connect with these functions. Function y equal to x is a straight line. Function y equal to x square will be a curve like this. Function y equal to sine x will be a wave function like this, and cosine function like this, and so on. Okay. So these are all kinds of dance moves which are connected with mathematical functions. Now I come to something really beautiful. There is something called Fibonacci numbers and the golden ratio. First of all, what is Fibonacci numbers? And Fibonacci was named after an Italian mathematician. And that's why it is called Fibonacci, just like Gucci. Okay. But then what are these numbers? The series start with 1 and 1. The first two elements are 1 and 1. Then the next element will be sum of the previous two. So you get 2. And the next element will be sum of 1 and 2. So you get 3. And then next will be 2 plus 3 is 5. And so on. You continue like this. Okay. The pattern is repeated and you get this series. Okay. Mathematically, you can express like this. This is about the person Fibonacci. I'm going to skip this. I'll come to the interesting part. You know, see the left-hand side, the diagram on the left-hand side, actually the smallest size rectangles, or I would say maybe squares, is 1 and 1. Okay. If you add 1 and 1, you get 2. Okay. So it's not just about adding 1 and 1. You add the sides of the square also. So add the sides of the square, you get the bigger square, which has a side 2. Right. So if you add this bigger square with side 2 and with side 1, you get 3. Okay. And if you add 3 with 2, you get 5. Right. If you add 5 with 3, you get 8. And if you add 8 with 5, you get 13. So this is what is happening. And you start drawing a curve starting from the smallest one corner of the smallest square and keep moving it in a diagonal form from smaller squares to the bigger squares. And you are able to move like this. You continue this process and you will be able to see what a beautiful pattern you could observe, which is similar to a pattern you see in the seashells. As I told you in the beginning, that it is language of nature. So wherever you see in nature beautiful things, symmetrical things or asymmetrical things, you can always connect it with mathematics. For example, if you look at lilies and irises, they come with 3 petals. Okay. The beauty of Fibonacci series or numbers, you will see, you know, at many places in nature, buttercups or wild roses with 5 petals. These are the elements of that Fibonacci series. Okay. Pawn marigold, black-eyed Susan with 21 petals. You can go around in your garden and you can also look for such flowers. Look at the banana. Either you could see that 3 flat sides or 5 flat sides. You can also look at scales in a pineapple and you can count 8, 13, 21, which are nothing but Fibonacci numbers. Now, going a little further, there is a relationship between Fibonacci numbers and golden ratio. And that ratio is actually some kind of constant. That constant is 1.618. Okay. So this is called phi, not pi, it is phi, okay? And it is referred to as golden ratio. So I don't want to go into the further details, but I want to tell you that where you could actually see the beauty of this golden ratio. I will skip this, I will come to this, okay? You know, you look at the first ratio, 1 divided by 1, these are the first two elements of the Fibonacci series, okay? Then you get 2 upon 1 because 1 plus 1 was 2. So the ratio is 2 upon 1. Then you get 2 plus 1 is 3. So 3 upon 2. Then you get 3 plus 2 as 5. So you get 5 upon previous number, 3. And you keep doing. So you are actually taking ratio of 2 consecutive numbers of the Fibonacci series, okay, which is mathematically you can say that B upon A is same as A plus B upon B. So A plus B is sum of these A and B. So the ratio will remain constant. And that constant has turned out to be 1.618, because if you start plotting this on a graph, you will see that they converge to a fixed number, and that number is 1.618. That's why this is called golden ratio and is represented by phi. Now, where do you see this golden ratio? Look at some of these stars in the flags of European Union or United States. You will be able to observe that occurrence of phi, that is the golden ratio. This is something very interesting. You know, out of these three blue colored rectangles, not each one of them is equally attractive. Now, if I were to ask you, and I'm not sure whether you can unmute, children, if they can unmute, can you tell? I mean, there is no standard answer, but you definitely will say that I like the left one most, or I like the right one most, or I like the middle one most, okay? So I don't know if you can unmute, you may be able to tell me out of these three, which one is most attractive?
In chat, there may be a couple of answers. Okay. Say middle okay. one.
Middle one.
Someone has said middle one.
Okay.
Not many people are writing. Children, you can write
Great.
Chat box.
Now, what I'm going to continue and tell you is that look at this. For the left one, the ratio to the sides is 1:1. It's a square. Length is to width. For the middle one, it is 2:1. Whereas for the third one, it is 1.618:1. And if you do a survey, you will find that most people will find the third one to be most attractive. And why it is attractive, nature tells us. You will find the applications in variety of fields in the design or art or architecture, advertising, packaging, engineering. I'll show you some pictures, okay? Book covers, windows, okay? Ancient buildings, playing cards, even the sculptors. Like, for example, if you look at these ancient architectures, you will be able to see the ratio, golden ratio, being used while designing these pillars or these sections in these ancient buildings. You are all familiar with this pyramid, Great Pyramid in Egypt. Again, if you look at the perimeter divided by twice its vertical height, it's actually phi, that is golden ratio. That's why it is so famous. You all know Mona Lisa. Why Mona Lisa painting has become so famous? It's because the length and width of the painting itself is again in terms of that golden ratio. If you draw a rectangle around Mona Lisa's face, from top of the forehead to the base of the chin and from left cheek to right cheek, you will notice that this also is a golden rectangle. That's why it is so beautiful. Another thing that you can try at home, you measure your arm length from the elbow up to the wrist and the full arm, okay, up to the fingertips. And you will again be able to take the ratio and you will end up in the golden ratio. Again, some of the examples that I'll show you for the golden ratio. Look at this human face. Dentists, they actually use this to make your smile look very beautiful. Again, there are some people who have beautiful eyes. And if you compare, you know, these two, the distances between two eyes and the width of an eye, and you compare this ratio, it will actually turn out to be a golden ratio. So the examples are countless. Baghdad City Gate, Dome of St. Paul, London, Great Wall of China. Even the design of front grill of the cars, guitar, you could see this. Even the fashion designers, certain design, apparels, they look very beautiful, as compared to others. So you could see this, you know, gauge comparing these two. Even the design of these household items. Look at the nature and animals and insects. Peacock feather, the sunflower. So perhaps, you know, when you go out in the garden and you'll start observing, you will see this, this interesting thing. Okay. Now I come to the second interesting application. There is a short crime story. A burglar robs a bank and escapes in a getaway car. He's chased by the police. The police takes a photograph, but the bad news is that the photograph is blurred. So what do we do now? There's nothing that you can do unless you improve the quality of the image. And here there are special mathematical functions which actually sharpen your image. Now you could see even in the mobile phones, these applications are there which actually are based on mathematical functions, which you know, they sharpen edges, they sharpen images, and you are able to get back the number plate. So that is the power of mathematical functions. So it is very, very useful in image processing. Nowadays, artificial intelligence and machine learning, they are based on all mathematics. So those who are looking at making a bright career can always look at pursuing artificial intelligence and machine learning in your higher studies. But then for that, you need to have a flair for mathematics. You need to have an appreciation for the beauty in mathematics, or the finer aspects of mathematics you should be able to understand and appreciate. So there are a lot of applications in image of image processing in computer graphics and special effects, televisions. Now I come to the last application. It is about a snowflake, which is very interesting. And the interesting part is that it has a finite area but infinite perimeter. Now, very difficult to believe, can something have a finite area but perimeter is infinite? Yes, it is possible. You start with an equilateral triangle, and then what you do, you make copies of this, smaller copies of the triangle, and add to each side. So you see in the center, you have the original triangle, but on each side, you have added a small triangle that also is equilateral. Okay. So you could see something, a shape like a star, but actually how you have made the star? By considering the original triangle and adding on each side equilateral triangle, okay, of a smaller size. You keep doing this, okay, for the next one. For the previous one, in the previous one, you had a star, right? And then on again, if you look at this, how many sides originally you had? Three sides. So you added three triangles, right? Now, how many sides do you have? You have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, right? Or maybe 12, I think I counted up. 12, okay? So in each of these 12, you add smaller triangles, and that is what you will get here. So you continue to repeat this process, and you will get a shape like this. And this is something which is going to, which resembles your snowflake, okay? So if you have been to a hill station, you would observe this. Now, coming to a bit of simple mathematics, if the area of this equilateral triangle is represented by A, area of the overall shape that we got in the second step is given by A plus 3 times A by 9. Why 3 times A by 9? Because you have added 3 small triangles, and each of the small triangle has an area 1/9 of the original triangle. And that is explained in this particular blank diagram, okay, without colors. So you could see there are 9 such triangles, okay? So each will have an area A by 9. Original area was A. So if you take A common, you get this one. Now, if you repeat this, area was A into 1 plus 3 by 9 in the first case. You could easily, you know, move to the next step when you will have 12 A by 81, because you are moving now by adding smaller triangles, okay? You can express this as a series, like A is common from all. So 1 plus 3 by 9, 3 into 4, 1 by 9 into 1 by 9. This is 1 by 81. This 12 is 3 into 4. And you continue like this up to, say, step N. Right? So you get an area. There is a formula for, you know, those who are familiar with arithmetic and geometric progression, they know the area. Okay? How to find the sum of the, sorry, how to find the sum of a geometric progression or an arithmetic progression. Okay. So you are able to get, you know, the area, if you continue like this, you will be able to get the area as 8A by 5. Okay. So A was the original area. 8 by 5 is the finite area, which you will get. Okay. Now I come to the perimeter part. Step one, this is the side of this is one side of the triangle of length L. Then if you add a smaller triangle, so what happens to the length now? The total length will become now, you know, L plus this additional part, which is 2 times L by 3. But then you have removed one else, okay? So it's actually L by 3 into 4, okay? So that's why 4 by 3 L. Then you again follow the same process for the next step, okay? So you will continue like this and you will get 4 by 3 square into L. So total length will be 4 by 3 to the power N L after N steps, okay? Now, you could observe that if you take the limit as L, n tends to infinity, this will become infinite. 4 by 3 is more than 1, so it will go to infinity. So, total length will go to infinity. Whereas, if you look at this area, it is going to be finite because the sum of a GP is, infinite GP is A upon 1 minus R. So A is the first term, R is the common ratio, which is 4 by 9. So 1 over 1 minus 4 by 9. And if you simplify this expression, you will be able to get this 8 by 5 A. So this area is finite, but perimeter is going to be infinite. So that is something interesting. If you want to explore further, you can actually work out whenever you have more time. Okay. So let me now come to more or less the conclusion part. This is a mathematics and humor, tau bhatija conversation. Bhatija says, pi lagu tau ji. And tau ji says, jita ro beta. Jita ro, jite ro beta. Okay. And what is the mathematics of life? If you add laughter to life, multiply love and subtract hate, what ultimately you get is happiness. And that is what we want all our children to have all the time, is to be happy, learn to be happy and discover how you can be happy. Okay. So I think there is another way to express the relationship between mathematics and life. Those who are familiar with integration, you integrate your happiness over time, from birth to death, and this is what is life. Okay. So time of birth is almost decided. You know your date of birth, but you don't know your date of death. So there are uncertainties of life, and we need to be aware of these things. Okay, so I would like to stop here and perhaps you know, take some questions or observations or comments from the participants.
Sure. but more. Yes, children would like to have questions in chat box. I don't see much of the questions they were answering when you were asking questions, or you were describing through slides. Some of the questions were answered during that time. Any questions are there? I can see not many hands raised. Should we allow? Okay, now question has come on. Oh, can you show the math humor page again, please?
I think which page?
Math humor. That Tau, I think.
Okay.
I will.
Just a sec.
Yeah, this one. Math.
Sorry. Is this?
I think, yeah, that's what I hope.
Maybe the child wants to take a
share,
picture.
Share? Yeah, he has thanked.
Okay, great.
Okay. If any questions, I will request, in fact, what will happen if we'll allow the speakers or unmute themselves, a lot many things will come. Then it becomes, so I'll write request if they can write the question. In fact, it has been, there's one more. What is the derivation of blurring formula?
Sorry, which formula? De-blurring formula. It actually requires the knowledge of Fourier transform. In fact, mathematical transform. And, someone who is familiar with the integral transforms, the concept of integral transforms, would know what is a Fourier transform and then inverse Fourier transform. So they can always, get the blurring and de-blurring done using the mathematical transforms. So actually, if you have exposure to higher mathematics, that is the integral transforms, then perhaps you can easily connect with the with each of these transforms which are used in image processing.
I think this is what they are sometimes say on TV screen. Sometimes you do not want to show the face, so they are using. I think that is the same case, same type of.
The back end formula or the back end transforms are mathematical transforms only.
Yeah. From image processing, that is based on some algorithm which comes.
Yeah, that's right. That's right. It's all mathematics at the back end.
So there is one. I think Lekha want to say that I did not understand area in the snow flake area. It will be available on Facebook page. I think you need to see it again and again, and see once again. Visit our website, Facebook page. He has very nicely and elaborately explained.
I think the question is about the perimeter being infinite and area being finite. I just want to repeat something. The total length at nth step will be 4/3 to the power n into l, the length of the basic segment. Right. Now, if you take the limit as n tends to infinity, this will become infinite because 4/3 is more than 1. Okay. Whereas, if you look at the area, if you look at the expression in the brackets inside, it can actually be expressed in terms of a geometric series. And in a geometric series, the sum of an infinite geometric series is A upon 1 minus R. So A is the first term and R is the common ratio. So what I have said here, if you take 3 common from all the terms, in fact, 3/9 common from all the terms, you get 3/9 here. So what is the first term? It is 1. And then common ratio will be 4/9. Okay. So yeah, that is the reason why it is written 1/(1 - 4/9). And after that, it is only a simplification. And that simplification gets you 8/5a. So here, it will remain finite. 8/5a finite, even if you go till infinity.
I think Lekha, maybe slightly on lower side of the class, you can say they need to understand more on, as you said, geometric progression, arithmetic progression, all those formula, then she may understand it slightly better. That would be.
No problem.
You can see this is something very interesting question. Even sometimes it comes to our mind that why does our eyes like the golden ratio? Because this is very peculiar. As you said, three rectangles when you have shown. In fact, I like the right one most. Somehow, it is there in the eyes. When we are going under a course, photo composition, when you frame compose a frame, there also every frame is not, we are not convenient with every frame. Sometimes it's very natural that a particular frame looks very nice, and that's how far as photographer compose frame. And it is true, they are using golden ratio. There is no doubt about that. And that's where the cameraman comes into picture. Director may direct, but if cameraman can spoil the entire movie, if they don't properly frame that. Okay.
So, absolutely right. Actually, what I wanted to tell the children, if they can do something at home, if they have a measuring tape, they can stand and measure from the top of their head up to the navel. Okay. And note down the length. And then measure their entire height, okay? And then try to see how close they come to the golden ratio. You will see some people will always have longer legs as compared to the upper portion, as compared to many others. You will see some people are more appealing when they stand just by sheer, and you can actually do this experiment by comparing, this height. And see, the more beautiful looks the models, especially the models, for them, this ratio is going to be very close to, I'm not saying exactly, but very close to golden ratio.
Oh, perhaps that's why when obese people or people who are having more weight, irregular shape, you can say, so we sometimes come across. So try to people maintain their figure. When they want to say maintain your figure and body, perhaps this is what they are actually meaning. They try to maintain the golden ratio, because utilizing others' eyes, but when they will see, you should look cool for that. Okay, Dr. Yadav, there is one question. How to solve mathematics in short time for those who are preparing for G advanced?
there is no shortcut to success. It's only hard work, perseverance, and patience. And I told in the beginning itself, that
understanding the concept,
you have to understand the concept, that's extremely important, and you need to show patience, you need to stay with the problem for a longer time. I think it is worth recalling what Einstein said. Einstein is regarded as a genius of the last century. What he said is he never used to accept that he's a genius. He used to tell, the only difference is I stay with the problem for a longer time. So that means he ponders over, he thinks over, he stays with the problem for a longer period of time. And if you do that, if you keep the problem in mind before going to bed, many a times you will actually get a solution in the morning.
I could not understand this question, but Dr. Yadav, why everything has the angle 90 degree?
Sorry, why?
Why everything has the angle 90 degree? E.g., TV, door or something. Okay. He's talking about look of that. For example, door, they have at angles, at corners, they have 90 degree angles. Okay. Or on TV also, the corners, they are always 90 degrees.
Right.
But I think 20-inch TV, when before this these LED and all that came, they were not exactly, or they were at that time also, they were 90 degrees.
Right.
That curvature shape.
The curved televisions or curved screens are still there. But even within the curved screens, I think the angle still will be 90 degrees. It's just that anything different from 90 degree may not be appealing to the eyes. That is one reason. The second, as far as the shape of the windows or the doors is concerned, gravity plays a major role. I mean, you have seen Leaning Tower of Pisa. It does not make 90 degrees angle. And likewise, any building or any structure that tilts, that actually defies the 90 degree angle, will always run the risk of falling. I mean, so there are, again, nature has its own way to handle these situations or these problems. But then angle different from 90 is also very important, very beautiful. You see parallelograms, you see many other shapes. It depends.
Rhombus, parallelograms, all those they have.
That's right. But it's very interesting. I'm so glad the children are asking very interesting and thinking very thoughtful questions. It's extremely nice and very pleasing to know that.
Okay, somebody's asking, can we leave? Yeah, they have class. So if they don't have any question, they can definitely. Is it true that seeds of fruits are in Fibonacci sequence for each of the dispersion? For example, bottle gourd, watermelon, cucumber. That's the question.
Number of seeds? Are they talking about number of seeds?
Seeds of fruits.
Fruits. Yeah. I don't know. I haven't observed. You may like to observe. I mean, perhaps, the child wants to know or wants to share that if the child has counted the number of seeds and they coincide with the number in the Fibonacci sequence.
Yeah, this should be the inspiration drawn from this lecture. Some of you can find out your own some place where you would like to apply this lecture, whatever you have learned or heard from Dr. Yadav. And send your observation to us. We'll share it with Dr. Yadav that I have, after this lecture, I have gone through this. Or maybe you can take, as he has said, measuring your own body length or some play, or going out. He has shown so many slides. Outside the window, you can find out in pictures, you can find out. Maybe you can select 10 different photographs from your archive and try to find out which looks much better to you and find out whether, is that the reason for that? So that I think will be a good exercise. Actually, there are many, but I think somewhere we have to stop. There are many questions, but you can write down and whatever will be there, we'll try to answer later on. Somebody is asking whether this PPT will be shareable. But see, this lecture will be available on Facebook. We have taken permission from Dr. Yadav. It is available. Those who want to see it again, they can. Only thing is, you have to go to our Facebook page. And perhaps after some time, it will be available on our YouTube channel as well. Okay?
There is nothing copyrighted. It's just that I have picked up many things from internet and many things from other sources. So it's just, compiling things and making it interesting. And I hope the children found it quite interesting and quite useful.
Okay, there is one question, but that is related to Rajesh. You can answer that and address that. I have a doubt about registration of NMD. Rajesh will address that. And all other thing, I think we can conclude this lecture right now here. I think I have liked it very much because even though we have gone through, but the way you have started, in fact, life is having a lot of mathematics. Whether I came across, you find out the word discipline, you find out the word attitude. If you start giving number AS1 and ZS26 and then try to add all those numbers. So mathematics is so lovely. And Dr. Yadav has told you, it is beautiful, it is handsome. And beautiful, handsome, these things, nobody should be fear about that. Nobody should have any fear about that. They are to be loved. Only thing is, if you'll understand this, it is not for cramming. It is not for rote learning. Try to understand it. That once you start understanding, you will enjoy it. And perhaps then you will start loving it also.
To an extent, that people have said that mathematics is a language for divinity. It actually is divine. If you try to find out more about pi, find out more about e, find out more about infinity, you will actually realize that it is divine. It's actually, the very, very divine thing.
Correct. And this equation I liked, one point. See, this is a very small one. Dr. Yadav started, I think, if children, those who are late or they have missed it, 1 to the power 365 means if you do something every day, same kind of thing, 360 days, it will lead to one only. But if you just have some extra 1% of that, 1.01 for 365, you end up having 37.7 extra. So that's what I think we can define so many things in mathematics, how to get better. It is, if you want to say 100, what is 100%? What is 101%? Try to find out all those things, and you will, it will be really interesting to note that your efforts, your day-to-day, what you are doing, they can be explained in that, about your attitude, about your discipline, all those things. Okay. So I think, Dr. Yadav, thank you very much. You have shown so many things. I have loved, like friendly numbers, 220, 284, many things we have come across. Investment, yeah. I'm big enough, so investing wisely, the rule of 72, that was also. See, it is very necessary to find out, and it can make you plan also. And now these children, they will be facing tomorrow the world, but it will be much useful. At least they will go informed to this world that somewhere they have learned about this, and they will not be unaware from this. So there are many things, math, dance, and the WhatsApp and Facebook, they come across through the lot many things, particularly during this day, National Mathematics Day, when we remember the genius Ramanujan. It always comes, so many things keep on coming. Okay, so thank you very much. Just I have one more announcement. For children, those who I can see many young faces here, don't miss the session on 24th, when we'll be having a storytelling session by Usha Venkatraman. She will address you live. It will be in the evening around 5:30, I think, because she will be addressing from US. So to match her, see, it will be very early morning in US. But she has agreed. And storytelling is also very, very important. We have experience about mathematics, about physics, about chemistry. So don't miss that. And those who want to play some games, join me on 24th itself at 4 o'clock, just before the storytelling session. We'll play some interesting games on mathematics.
Yes. I have a 1 minute video on Ramanujan.
If yes, you please, permit, we can share. Yes, yes.
If you permit, yes, sure. I can just share it. You know,
I think that will be a real tribute on this day.
Yeah. So I think, is it visible now?
Yeah, it is visible. You can play.
Srinivasa Ramanujan was born at Erode in Tamil Nadu. Ramanujan's instruction to formal mathematics began at the age of 10. With almost no formal training in pure mathematics. Ramanujan developed his own mathematical research in isolation. As a result, he sometimes rediscovered known theorems in addition to producing new work. Ramanujan found his mentor in G.H. Hardy, the renowned English mathematician. Ramanujan made extraordinary contributions to mathematical analysis, number theory, infinite series, continued fractions, and the Ramanujan conjecture. Lately, Ramanujan's cryptic deathbed theory, which he claimed was conceived in his dreams, has finally been proven correct, almost 100 years after he died. In 1920, while on his deathbed, Ramanujan wrote a letter to his mentor, English mathematician G.H. Hardy, outlining several new mathematical functions never before heard of, along with a hunch about how they worked. Ramanujan's theory on cryptic functions, which was in oblivion for 90 years, came into the limelight, and that in the National Year of Mathematics, 2012. Ramanujan was a genius parallel by none. It's high time that India generates more mathematicians of his caliber. Bureau Report, DD News.
So it was a small tribute from Doordarshan and a video made by Doordarshan. I thought it is befitting on this occasion to let our young children know the great mathematical genius.
Yes, they must.
Yeah.
And that is the main idea of this celebration when in 2012, when it was, I think, 125 years when Government of India declared that from that year onwards, 22nd December will be celebrated as National Mathematics Day. The whole idea is that young children should be enthusiastic, they should learn, and they should come forward and contribute to the mathematics. They need not to be afraid of that. Okay, so thank you, children.
There was a small comment from one of the attendees that yes, the mug or the cups that we use to drink water or to drink tea or coffee, Yes, you also follow this man, you know, the golden ratio. I think it actually, you will see some cups or mugs will always look more beautiful than the rest.
Yes.
So you could try it out and see how closely they come, you know, to the golden ratio.
I think in nutshell, we can say, or people should try it out. As I said, find out some different objects and find out which object you are not liking, which object you are liking, or it is appealing you. And then do this calculation, whether they are in some golden ratio. And if it is yes, you should. It is a discovery, we can say. You have made some very good discovery for that. And share it with Dr. Yadav. He will be happy to that.
Yeah, that will be really nice.
Yeah. So thank you, sir. Thank you for sparing time and sharing your collection. Wonderful things with our children. I think even though they are young, but they have enjoyed. There was nothing that they could not follow. You have made it simple and use it also. There are certain things which cannot go beyond certain level, but still, I think every bit of it was understandable, comprehensible. Thank you, children.
Thank you very much. It was a great experience for me to be with the young children today and share with them some of the exciting things of mathematics. And I appreciate the time and patience that they have shown. Yes. I appreciate the effort of the parents who have been instrumental in motivating and encouraging kids to pursue mathematics and other science subjects. So it has been a real pleasure for me to be a part of this session. And once again, I thank the organizers, Nehru Science Center, Mumbai, and Mr. Umesh Rustagi. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Okay, children, we are concluding now. See you tomorrow, day after. We have 2 more days to go for this celebration. Okay, bye. Thank you.